Nancy Newton Covington Axel, or all my monikers. I was born in Seattle on May 18th, 1930. And my dad was a meat dealer. He provided meat for hospitals. And my mother was a stay-at-home mother that wanted to work, but in those days it wasn't, you know, men didn't like their wives working. So she was always kind of wish she'd had a career. But anyway, I went to Franklin High School and the University of Washington, and I studied home economics. But then I decided I really wanted to be a teacher, and I didn't want to teach girls stitching and cooking. I liked smaller children, so I got a teaching certificate and worked for a while at Bellevue Community College in early childhood education, and then worked on Mercer Island teaching kindergarten for quite a few years. So that was a career that was very rewarding, and I enjoyed it. And of course, teaching art in kindergarten is lots of fun. So, and had my four children. There were 10 years in between, the first two and the second two, so it was a lot of years there with children. And they're all grown now, of course. Well, I always, you know, liked to draw, as most artists, and when I was 10, a lady in our neighborhood, actually she was a well-known artist, Olive Malmstrom Carl was her name, and she was a watercolorist, and she gave lessons, so I went to her and took some lessons, and that started me on a 77-year journey of loving watercolor, and I still love it. So after that, in grade school, I won a scholarship art contest. That gives you a boost, you know, it's validation. And so in high school, I took art. And then when I went to college, to the University of Washington, I minored in art. So I took from some wonderful people out there. And one that stands out is Viola Patterson. She and her husband Ambrose Patterson were both well-known artists, and she was very good. I learned a lot from her. I had a good friend, her name was Myra, and we liked to paint together. We traipsed all over Seattle, painting boats and landscapes and things. And then both of us got married, started raising children, and then it was a little harder to fit the painting in. So for many years I did all kinds of arts and crafts. They didn't somehow absorb as much, you know, time and effort. And so I was always active in art things, but I kind of put it on the back burner. Well, I had four children. So in the early 80s was when Jenny Reese and I met. And we decided to take a watercolor class together on Mercer Island. And that really kick-started me back into my love of painting. So from that time on, I've really been very active and...
Well, my husband was a watchmaker besides being a Boeing engineer. And her daughter lived in Alaska, and she wanted her watch fixed. She had a nursing watch or something, I think it was. And so my husband fixed the watch for her, and Nancy brought it up to the house, and she gave him a pair of mukluks that she made. Her daughter made mukluks. And she gave him a pair of mukluks for doing her watch. And that's how I met Nancy.
I didn't know that was the first time.
Yeah, that was the first time. I think I'd seen you, but I hadn't,
formally
talked much. I knew who she was and everything.
Yeah. I think that was the early 80s.
Yeah, it was early 80s.
Yeah. It's going to make me tear up. We've been friends for so long. It's meant a lot because we did so many things together and supported each other in our art, and we belong to the same organizations, the Mercer Island Visual Arts League, Women Painters of Washington, and Northwest Watercolor Society. So we were active on the boards of those, and Jenny was president of two of them, and I was president of the Watercolor Society. So we were kind of
in all of this
together.
We've been friends
and enjoyed the same thing.
We could talk about the things, same thing. She knew what I was doing and I knew what she was doing, and we'd talk about different art things.
And we took a lot of workshops together,
yeah,
so that workshops. Was where we really enjoyed watching each other paint too. Painting is a solitary thing, so it's always good to have somebody to talk with about things, and we've done a lot of that.
Yeah, we have.
I belong to the Mercer Island Visual Arts League, Women Painters of Washington, and that was kind of a thrill because this Olive Malmstrom Carl, who was my first teacher, she was a former president of that organization, so I knew she was gone by that time, but I knew she'd be proud that one of her students became accepted there. And then the Northwest Watercolor Society, I've really been more active in for a long time. And I was president in 1995 and 96. So, and I've been continually on the board for 23 years. And every time I try to get off, they say, no, we want you back. And so, it's been really rewarding because they're wonderful people on that board. It started in 1939 with three ladies in their 20s, young ladies, who decided it would be a good idea to start a watercolor society. And at first they didn't know whether they'd invite men or not, but they finally did. And you know, your dad was a former president of the Watercolor Society, so you know a little bit about it. But it has grown from this small group of people that banded together early on. Now we have about 800 members. It's an international society. We have members all across the USA and Europe and China. We're getting Sri Lanka, and a lot of these people are entering our exhibitions, which is interesting too. So, and it's just a wonderful society. When we had our 60th anniversary in 1999, and I was co-chair of that, but the real thrill for me was I was curator of the show we had at the Fry Art Museum. So that was my first step into being an actual curator, and that was terrific. And then in 2015-16, we celebrated our 75th anniversary. And my biggest thrill there was working on the book that we produced. And that's going to be a wonderful legacy of the Watercolor Society. So I've never done it before, but I was editor, researcher, and collaborator, and three of us worked together on it. David Martin, wonderful, wonderful art historian in Seattle, and Molly Mira, who did the design work. We worked together for a year, and we're all still good friends. We had our differences, but we ironed them all out. And so the society, I mean, we offer so much to our members because we have workshops, we have demonstrations, we have paint outs, we have a fabulous newsletter, just so many things that people can do. Give scholarships to students.
That's great.
Well, one was Jess Cawthorn, a fantastic artist that's been in the Northwest for so many years. He's gone now, but he taught at Bellevue Community College, and again, Jenny and I went for several years to his classes. He was Mr. Watercolor. He knew all of the interesting techniques and things that we need to learn about it and framing. And he really gave us a good boost. And then also Jenny and I have taken a lot of workshops together. Judy Betts, the Watercolor Society, when they give the two workshops a year, they have national jurors that give the workshops. So they're all really noted artists, and that's another wonderful way to further your career by working with these great artists. I always like to say paint, paint, paint. That's the main thing. Just keep working, because you learn so much every painting you do. But also finding good teachers and studying and joining these art organizations are great too, because they usually have people that will do workshops and do, you know, networking with other artists can be very valuable, because it's not only painting. If you're going to be selling your art, you need to know a little bit about how to market your art, how to frame your art, how to take pictures of it to send to exhibitions. And I do think entering juried shows, you learn a lot. And I always tell people about the Northwest Watercolor Society, our open show that we have every year that's open to everybody in the USA and the world. We get fabulous work. One year it was won by a gal. It was the first time she'd ever entered a show. She won first prize. So don't ever give up. And, you know, being an artist is dealing with rejection, because you enter a lot of things and you don't get in, but you just keep up, and pretty soon you're finding that you're doing well and selling your work, and that's always validation too. Well, raising four children and trying to do your art when it's a career, or part-time career, is always challenging, trying to work, fit it in. But also, watercolor is such a challenging medium. You never really, you know, master it, but also that's the beauty of it, because it's so fluid and surprising, the results. You never know exactly how it's going to turn out. But I would say that my second husband, Dick Axel, was one of my big boosters. He was such a wonderful support system to me and really encouraged me, so that helps.
Yeah.
It's constantly a joy. It's a personal joy when you complete a painting that you feel good about and you feel came to tell a story that you had in your mind when you saw the scene. And I've had several paintings that have been kind of popular, and one is, I'll show it to you, it's Me and Dad, this is called, and it was a man and his little boy walking down the street that I took a picture of and then did this painting. I've sold so many prints, it seems to strike a chord in people, this feeling of the father-son relationship. And there was a family that was visiting here from the east, and they saw it in a gallery, and they came out here with their two-year-old son because he had leukemia, and they were at the children's hospital. So they bought that painting and framed it and gave it to the doctor to thank him for all they did for their, and they felt that it was very close to the way their little boy looked. And then, I don't know if you know Child Haven. It's a big organization in Seattle that works with abused children and their parents. They work with both. And a friend of mine who was on the board bought a print of this and framed it and put it in the counseling room where they talked to the parents of abused children. And they felt it was a good positive role model of a father-son relationship. So those are things that really make you feel so good about your painting when it reaches people like that.
Yeah.
Well, for instance, when I go to a show that has oil and watercolor, I pass right by the oil. I just love the look, the fluidity, the beautiful colors of watercolor. And then it's the same with painting it. There's just nothing like flooding that onto a piece of paper and seeing what happens. And I've just always loved watercolor. I enjoy oil paintings, but it doesn't strike me the same at all.
Do you regret the investment in the organizations rather than just spending all your time in art?
No, because I enjoyed that part of it too. And for instance, now I'm at a senior community center, living place, and I'm running an art gallery. So it's part of my nature, I guess, to organize and run things. So. I'm enjoying that.
Well, Nancy is my rock solid person. She keeps us all grounded. She knows about everything.
No, I wouldn't say that.
She does. She does. She's been on the board of Northwest for so long, and she keeps them on track. And she keeps everybody on track. Mm. It's just amazing how she does it. I'm not that good. That's right.
But here's the problem. Jenny's still painting. I got involved so much in running an organization.
Yeah.
I'm not painting anymore.